All right, everybody, welcome to a Friday Night Breaks featuring the one and the only Anthony J. Carter, all the way from Kansas City in here to run the show tonight. Yo, Bowman Baseball Dual Box Hobby is up next. Also, remember, we're doing hitless tracking for Flawless, so if you don't get any cards, which unfortunately many of you will, I'm going to run the list on Saturday night, depending how late it goes. If not, it'll be Tuesday, and we'll award some cool stuff for hitless! Well, I don't think you want to listen to that two times in a row now, do you? Yeah. Eric, put that on there. I like that version better. There's y'all's teams. Who's Johnny? Like it's a fresh case crack kind of night. Okay. freshly picked by Tommy. Good luck. Blue Jays and Giants, well, that's dope. Martin Clark. Maybe I'll do a Martin Clark Invitational where you have to be invited to do a Bowman break. Martin would tell me who he wants to be invited. He will put up his Tom Brady 1-of-1 auto that I think he should just take the money for. Just saying, Martin, the way you have to look at it is the amount of money that you're thinking about getting for that card. Think about the Tom Brady type of items you could buy with that type of money, like versus a card. I mean, you could get game-worn jerseys probably, or footballs, actual game-used footballs signed and stuff like that versus a card. That's my opinion. There's a lot. And Carter's trolling me because he knows he put in, he didn't even do a dual box or a single box Bowman. He added in one of these because he knows I have to sell these, so that's dope. Blaze Jordan. Do we get an autograph of this guy? I don't even think we got a Blaze Jordan yet. Bryce, Mario, and Corey Ray. Who's Johnny? She said, in a special way. I think these are 36 packs, or is it 24? Yeah, I just looked. I saw that it was one hobby, one jumbo. Carter wouldn't troll me. He tries, but I'm untrollable. There's Blaze. Who has those Red Sox? Dave K with the Red Sox. That's good. Dom. Austin Martin. Oh, that's big. This guy. Like I said, I have no idea how or who does multiple cases of this stuff in breaks. I mean, that's no offense, but it's the most boringest thing ever to me. It's okay to do it in a, you know, in this format, one or two boxes at a time. Something dope could come out because I do like the cards. But I think to sit here and do this for 4 hours opening the same product. Pass. All I'd be thinking about, if I had to do a double case break of this Bowman, all I'd be thinking about was, man, what would have been in the Chronicles that we opened, or the Select, or the Flawless, or the National Treasures. Dylan Carlson, shiny. Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. I don't want to take 4 days to open up one product. I got too many other products I got to move. And I want to see opened. Ed Howard. There's a Casey Martin. I just trickle through this little by little. Uh-oh. Look at this. What if this is the auto? I think it's a true gold to 10. No auto, but it's Jordan Adams, 75. I thought it was gold 10. 17th overall. That's got to be a great card for the Angels. T. Sext. What up, Tim? Starting to get breaker paranoia. There better be an auto in here. I'm gonna have to go back through all these freaking things. Breaker paranoia brought to you by Tops. Oh, of course it was last. Thank God. I can't tell you the relief you have when you see that auto. Luis Santana, H-Town. So did you guys see the viral video portion of, what's his name, Logan Paul? Ripping off Mayweather's hat and running away, and then they wanted to fight. Oh yeah, Tommy would love that. If you have seen that video, my question is, do you think that was legit, or did they plan that? Sorry, my mic is getting loose and it's not staying where I want it. You think it was staged? I don't know, man. When somebody's really angry, you can kind of tell. Unless they're really, really good actors at it. I mean, they might have said, look, let's just... They might have just kind of been unplanned. I mean, plan to do something crazy, like take a swing at each other or tackle each other or something. They probably just kept it real low key and kind of a non-verbal thing saying, we're going to make this good. And then that's what he decided to do. And maybe Mayweather wasn't ready for him to do that. He thought maybe he was going to push him around a little bit, you know? And he ended up you never rip another man's hat off, dude. You do not do that. You want to get in a serious fight, go into a bar at like midnight, talk smack on some dude, and take his hat off. And throw it. No. Oh, it definitely, and it works. It worked, too, you know. Because I watched it. Luis Robert. Is he still out? There's a Blaze Jordan for you. Ed Howard. I think we had an Ed Howard auto the other night, didn't we? I can tell you this. I can tell you this. If that was totally legit and unplanned and unscripted, and he ripped off Floyd Mayweather's hat like that and ran off and embarrassed him like that and disrespected him like that, Logan Paul is dead. I mean, he is dead. He's going to get killed in the ring. I can tell you that much. It's all I kept thinking was, man, if this is real and he did that to him, he's dead. There ain't going to be no exhibition about this now. And which is good. That's what you want. Because I'm going to freaking buy it. I may even take breaks off to watch it. Oh, is it Jake? No, I get them mixed up. I don't even know who the hell they are, to be honest. I thought there was only one. So there's Jake and there's Logan Paul. Hi, Shammy. So who ripped his hat off? The guy that's fighting him? Not the guy who's fighting him. I don't get it. I thought the guy that was fighting him ripped his hat off. See, shows you how much I know about these Paul fellas. And I thought they were YouTube stars. There's Brady and Carcion, number to 250. He's fighting Logan, but Jake is the trash talker. Marlins. Cabrian Hayes. Man, wonder how much a Cabrian Hayes Bowman auto would sell for in this. Probably a lot. So to be clear, the dude that ripped off Mayweather's hat today is not the guy he's fighting. Why was he in his face? I think the dude he's fighting is who took his hat. Wouldn't make any sense if his brother did it. Okay, so that was probably real then, because why would they stage that? That doesn't really, I don't know. I don't think it was planned. I don't think they literally said, okay, you're going to come up, you're going to step in, you're going to take my hat, I'm going to act real mad, and we're going to cause a scene. I don't think they did that. I think they just kind of say, look, dudes, let's give the people what they want. Let's make this good. And then that's what happened. But it kind of backfired. Because you don't take off another man's hat. Just an unwritten rule, I think. That's my personal opinion. Not necessarily the reflection of Top Shelf Breaks. Oh, you mean that? Yeah, he really did knock him out too, because from the one angle, you could say, oh, he took a dive. But then if you really watch it from the crowd's angle, he got lit up, man. He got caught on the chin. It looked pretty legit to me. Now, he probably got caught on the chin. You know, it's like a half-ass thing, you know? They need it to look real. So he's probably like, dude, if you knock me out, you knock me out. Oh, people are paying. People want it. Gives you something to talk about, like right now. It's pop culture. That's what happens today in pop culture. Some people say it's ruining and the hobby, the sport of boxing is over, dead, finito. Others say no. The sport of boxing is actually thriving right now. And I say, well, I kind of disagree with that because these guys are like manufactured boxers and it certainly isn't like the days of the 80s boxing. I mean, I think if these guys are such badasses, why don't they step into the octagon without gloves? How about that? You want to be a badass? Then fight. Then just fight each other. Why don't they do that? Answer me that question, guys. Why don't they just fight each other? Street fight. That's what basically UFC is, street fighting, in a way. A little bit more controlled. Oh, yeah. You take their hat off and run around. I know, it is, man. I'm pretty sure it's happened to me over the years. That's why I feel that way. Take someone's hat off, man. Or it flipped their, when they flip your hat, someone flips your hat off. Forget it. Yeah, for sure. Well, when is that? That's next month, right? June? That's the other thing. They don't waste any time anymore. Back in the day, it was like, okay, September 19th. No, they're cranking them out. First Bowman of Adinzo Reyes. Number 125. Well, see, that wasn't so bad. Two boxes, I'm done. I'm good. I want to move on to something else. We can come back and do more, but I want to move on to something else. Like, I could probably do a case break of this in a night, but I have to do it in blocks. Tyson Fury. I like him. Stand against the wall. Coming from a principal, he knows these things. Take a cowboy's hat in Texas? Oh, you're also dead. Oh, my word.